I am Aditi with my teammate Diksha, and we are here to present our project, Automation of Certificate Generator. Let's start with the introduction. Basically, Automation of Certificate Generator is a web-based tool to generate digital certificates. Here, the users are organizer. So we made this project from the point of organizer. Here, organizer can log in, then create an event, add participants and their basic information, can generate certificates, view certificate, add it, and then send certificate to its participants via mail. And for every certificate, we generate a unique QR code, so participant can verify their certificate. And our certificate verification is secured using hashing. Here we are using SHA-128. So why the project is important? Here's the purpose of the project. As we all know, in today's world, most of the workshops and the nano degree programs are held online. So there's very much need to send the certificates to participants. And sending hard copy certificates not that reliable, so it is very easy and reliable to send digital certificates to a large number of participants at a time. Here we are using hashing techniques, so this is secured using hashing. Digital certificates are part of a developing set of technologies, and we can address here like today's security using hashing, identity, so participants can verify their certificate, accessibility issues, like we directly mail the certificates to participants' email ID. These are the technologies we used: Python for backend, Django for database, LaTeX. Using LaTeX we are generating the digital certificate, and HTML, CSS and Bootstrap for our front-end designing. This is the basic database, a class diagram of our project. Like we created these classes, and they have their attributes and functions, and there is relationship between the classes, like one-to-one, one-to-many, how the different classes are related to each other. Now Diksha will give us an overview of the project.
Good evening, everyone. So I'll be giving a brief overview of the project. So as organizer would log in, then he could create an event, then he can add a certificate. So what's meant by adding a certificate? It's like adding a zip folder which will contain a LaTeX template, .tech file, and that and also the related things which that LaTeX file needs. So there are basically some formats and rules we have defined for that LaTeX file's name and everything. We'll cover them up later. Then organizer can organize an event. So what's the difference between create an event and organize an event? It's like event is like, suppose, a Java workshop. So organizing, we can organize the Java workshop many number of times. So he can put the event entry in the event table and organize event entry in the organized event table. So it's like that. And then he can add the participants. So we know that these workshops, they have large number of participants. So it's like we have made a feature like adding a CSV file. The first line, there's also a format associated with it that the first line would contain the name of the organized event, and then from second line onwards there would be the details of the students. So, and the last, he would send the certificates to the students. So the second thing is the verification. So there's basically a QR code in the certificate of the students, so student can just copy that QR code and paste it on the link given, and they can actually see that their details and the organized event name. We'll show you in the demo. And there's also a picture of the QR code in the certificate, so he or she can scan it also and verify their details also. So I'll show you the demo. So this is the front page of our website. So there are various options associated here. The profile of the organizer, it is this, and he can add a user. So add here, we have given the CSV file. You can choose the CSV file, and if it click submit, then automatically the details would be added to our database. The second thing is certificate, add and view certificate. You can add a certificate. He can choose a template. So template, as we said earlier, that these are the rules for template. That template must be a zip file, and there are various rules, variables available. Actually, the tech file, it would contain, actually in every tech file we have to substitute the name and all the details of the participant. So we have created, like we have put a dollar with the variable name, so that thing would be replaced with the student's name and whatever things like event name and everything. So these are the variables available till now. We can also extend it in our database. So this is the basic format. He can give a title to the certificate. Second is the view certificate. So he can actually view those certificates he has like uploaded. So for example, I click on the preview button, and now the LaTeX has been converted to PDF, so it's taking some time. So here the preview has been downloaded. You can actually see the certificate, like we have just put some dummy names, test first name, test last name. This is the QR code, and this is the like the serial number. He can copy and paste it in our link, on our link website, and he can verify it. So this is basically the like sample certificate we've got from FOSSI. So this was all about preview. Then he can add an event, create an event. So he can choose from the certificates available. He has already uploaded some certificates. He can choose that, and he can give the name to the event. He can organize an event. Like this is event name, start date, end date, organizer's name, place, and participants. And the last one is the sending of certificates. So suppose he wants to send the certificate to, like this is the sample organized event, name test one. And suppose this is the mail sent already. So suppose here mail hasn't sent, so I'll click the send all button, or I can also send individual mails to the participant. So mail sent successfully, and here it has turned green. So it was all about the demo, about the website. So Aditi would, we have verify also. Suppose this is the sample, this thing we have kept here. If we click verify, then all the details would be shown of that serial number or QR code, like who has the QR code in that certificate. All the details would be shown here. So this was all about the demo. Now Aditi would go on with the future scope.
As we designed this project at this point from the organizer point of view, but this can be extended from the student's point of view. As the authentication system for participants, so they can view and edit their details after the mail sending, generate certificate PDF from other software than LaTeX. Like right now we are using LaTeX, but we can use other also. Features for participants to add their opinion and review on the events. Like after we are sending the certificates to the participant, then they can also review and mail us any issues if they are regarding. So this is the future scope.
So thank you.
Bulk certificate generation?
Actually then it would be in like spam. So we have created like some time gap between, like suppose we send 40 certificates at once, then.
No, not sending. Can you generate bulks,
say
20,000 certificates based on, because you have many participants, right?
Hmm. So yeah.
Or are you going to generate one by one?
Actually, we can generate like when the mail is being sent, so it's what it's doing that.
All at a time.
It's doing, it is substituting the values of, substituting the name and everything of the participant in the LaTeX file, and then it is converting it to PDF. So for every participant, it is doing like that.
Oh, okay.
So in bulk, we can generate. It's the same actually what we are doing, like if we are converting it to the PDF, or suppose some XYZ participant is there, we are converting, we are making it certificate, then we are deleting it from the database because it's no longer required.
After sending mail, we delete it from our system. That's it. Next
then
time we can.
How do you verify?
Verification is done through the database. We are storing the details of the participants and the organized events in our database. So we are verifying it from that only.
And what you are deleting?
We are deleting the PDF generated.
Oh, PDF.
Just the PDF.
That's
generated.
Fine. And how do you import the data, the large number of participants, student participants?
Through that CSV file only, like.
CSV file.
Yeah.
Any number of candidates.
Like there's a format given, like the first name, then last name, then college, if there's some.
Name correction, if you want to do.
Name correction of the participant. Yeah, he can.
Yes,
he can do it. Actually, we have.
In view, all the edits we can, like he can edit certificate title, event.
Like in view users, he can actually correct the.
He can edit and then save in all organized events.
Can you also create certificates for an event which was not organized by your software?
No.
they had this option, na, organized events and then certificate, right?
No, if the event is not
that
organized.
Is just to capture the start date. And
acha, okay. Otherwise, you can just say generate certificates for this template. That is possible, right?
We can preview it, of course.
Yes, sir.
The template, we can preview
templates
it.
Templates, we can generate.
But we can generate the certificate for the organized event.
Nee, non-organized events, if I have now organized on in the past and now I get your software, I have to generate some 20 certificates.
Like you have to generate it again?
No. Nee, fresh, yes, first time, but I had not used your software to organize the event.
Okay.
You got start date and end date. Can I generate a certificate before the end date?
Now it's doing that. Sir, any more corrections, sir? So because we will improve it like in 1 week or something.
Good job.
Thank you, sir.